Hola, hola, hola! Welcome to Astronaut. For today's video, we have a special topic, Incan astronomy. This was fresh on my mind because I just came back from visiting my grandpa in Peru. But as a prelude to this video, I want to note that I am not a historian, just an astronomer interested in learning about the ways others perceive and relate to astronomy. Like an astronaut in what you know about rolling down in the deep. For the Incas, perceptions of astronomy were intertwined with religion and agriculture. So to understand how the Incans viewed astronomy, we have to first look at the broader belief system. The Incans viewed the world in three parts: the upper world, Nan Pacha, the middle world, Kay Pacha, and the lower world, Udru Pacha. Pacha is a Quechuan term meaning earth or world. By the way, Quechua is not only the language of the Incas, but is spoken by about 8 million people today, mostly in the mountainous regions of Peru and Bolivia. The Incas depicted animals as links to these three worlds, within art and, as we will see shortly, constellations. The condor, one of the only creatures to fly high within the Andes, was a link to the upper world, the puma, a link to the middle world, and the snake, which kept the ground, a link to the lower world. Such animals can be seen in the Incan representation of the Milky Way. The Incans described constellations not only in the stars, but also in the dark patches of the sky. In the dark clouds of the Milky Way, the Incans watched for the appearance of figures like the llama, the tinamou, and the serpent. The appearance and disappearance of these constellations foretold the end and beginning of a harvest and often aligned with the activity of Andean animals. Machu Picchu, one of the most famous Incan ruins, was the center for both sacrificial ceremonies and agricultural production. There, large containers of water were set out to reflect the skies, and the alignment of familiar constellations, like the Pleiades, were used to predict harvest trends. It's also important to note that the precision of many Incan calculations was impeccable and emphasized the significance they placed in astronomy. The north and east-facing windows of the Sun Temple in Machu Picchu marked significant days in the Incan solar calendar, starting from the shortest day of the year and building up to the longest day. While Incan practices are no longer prevalent in present-day society, Peru is a country that often looks to its past. And as astronomers, we carry the task of looking back, looking forward, and of course, looking up. With this in mind, we continue to ponder, wander, and write in the stars.